In this video, you're gonna learn about how to develop your personal brand. And this is a series of free videos where we're also gonna talk about how to launch your personal brand, monetize it, and even scale it. But first, on the subject of developing your personal brand, the first thing that you should be aware of is that you already have a personal brand. We all do, in fact. It's simply how people and the world perceives you. So whether you are in a career that you're just not fully satisfied with, and you plan on moving into a career path that really fulfills you, and you plan on working your way up the ranks at that company, or whether you plan on starting your own venture or business, or maybe you already have, developing your personal brand is one of the most underutilized resources and tools that most people aren't fully aware of leveraging properly. So in this video, we're simply gonna cover how to develop your personal brand, and we're gonna make this very easy and just cover a lot of the basics and foundational things for you to know and for you to be able to start doing in order to develop your personal brand. So the first thing that we talked about is perception. How the world perceives you is the first thing to be aware of. And so on that note, think about it for a minute, that if people look you up online, what are they gonna find? How could they judge you and perceive you simply based on what they see online? So hiring managers make their final decisions in most cases to hire you or anybody who's a candidate based on what they see online. So the first thing to realize is your online personal brand and perception and online resume is the first thing that you should be aware of. What are you posting on social media? What are you, commenting back? What are you maybe not posting on social media that almost makes you invisible and a ghost online, which means that the only thing that I have as a reference point is the perception others have of you. So when you talk about developing your personal brand, you really want to be aware of controlling the perception that you want people to perceive you. So if you start posting specific things online and developing a personal brand online in a way that controls the perception, so if someone goes and looks you up, they're all going to perceive you in a very similar way, or in addition to, you start being aware of your perception that others are having of you based on how you're showing up, how you're communicating, how you're dressing. All of these things play a role and how other individuals could quickly come to a label or a judgment or a perception of who you are. Whether it's right, wrong, or neutral, the first thing to understand with developing your personal brand is being massively aware of how you can start to control the perception that others will have of you. The reason why that's important is because if you plan on transitioning from the career that you're currently in into a new career that's going to be more long-term for you, that switch, the people who maybe they call on as a reference, probably have a perception of you. And if you haven't been controlling that perception, when you plan to make the switch and your hiring manager calls your old boss or employees or colleagues, and you haven't controlled that perception, you don't know necessarily what will be said. So if you can control it, there's a higher probability you can control getting the job you want. That's why it's so important. If the hiring manager at your new career looks you up online and you haven't been controlling the narrative and the perception on social media and on the internet about what you've been posting, then you're probably not controlling the likelihood of getting that job. If you plan on working your way up your current career, it's the same thing. Controlling your perception has the biggest influence first on making sure that your personal brand is really being utilized in your favor, and you're not willy-nilly hoping that what someone says about you is what you want. You're controlling it. Maybe you have a venture or a business that you've started or that you're part of. People usually, nowadays, will simply look up on the internet for online reviews from past customers and clients. They might even look out and see what you've been posting on social media as a business. Research shows that nowadays, most consumers, before making a purchase decision for a product or a service with a company, usually go online to see other people's reviews or to see content posted by the company itself. And so again, if you have your own venture or business or plan to, really making sure you're controlling the perception of what prospects, customers, and clients and partners will perceive about you in that environment and context is also very important to helping you build the business, have the growth and the income that you really want and that you deserve. So again, in any of these categories, developing your personal brand and first knowing how to control the perception is the first important way to take control of leveraging your personal brand. And now that we have that covered, we move into the more broad understanding of what industry are you in. So if you're in a career, then you want to transition into a new, you know, career and workplace, what is that industry? Develop your personal brand for the job you want, not the job you have. And if you have a job right now and you plan on moving into starting your own business, develop your personal brand and perception and strategy based on the business you want to start. So you're not doing it if you're in a place where you say, I don't want to use my personal brand for what I have, use it for where you want to be. And so that's the important thing. Act as if you already have the job. Start building your personal brand and perception for that. And then if you already have a business, you want to make sure that you understand the industry you're in, which is very simple. You're in sales, you're in health and wellness, you're in pharmaceuticals, you're in real estate. Very simple. You would start to build your personal brand, develop it and leverage it, and the perception in that industry. Which then moves us into the more specific industry. We now know the perception we want in the industry we are in or plan to be in, and now we're going to get into the niche. What specific audience are you going after? So, for example, if you know that you're in the real estate industry, you probably sell low-income homes, affordable housing, you might sell commercial real estate, you might sell homes, you might help people buy homes, you might do refinance and mortgage. There's all these different niches within the industry of real estate. So what niche are you specifically speaking to so that now you're not just controlling the perception for the industry, but you're controlling your perception just for the audience you're speaking to? Which brings us down to the next point, which is the target audience within the niche. For example, you could help people buy and sell homes, and you could help people buy and sell homes that are older. You could help people buy and sell homes for their very first time. You could help people with investment homes, buying and selling investments. You could help people that are a specific income, that are a specific age, that are in a specific geographical location, in a city, in a state, in the world. The industry is the broad industry that you're in. The niche is the more specific category within the industry, and the target audience is the exact specific individual that you're really developing your personal brand to speak to. So you don't want to speak to everybody. You want to speak to a specific individual. Now, if anyone were to look you up, they would probably have a perception of you for being the best individual for that audience. So I could look you up if your personal brand was to be the top health and wellness blogger for millennial girls 25 to 32, and I looked you up, your personal brand and perception might not be for me, and that's okay if I don't fall into your target audience and your niche. So your perception that you're going to develop your personal brand around needs to be speaking to an audience so that it's specific. Because when you speak to everyone, you speak to no one. And there's an old saying in the business world and marketing, the riches are in the niches. And so when you develop your personal brand, you don't want to try to be a celebrity to the whole world. You want to be someone who stands for something, someone who is the best, someone who has a certain perception for a target audience so that instantly that customer knows your product is for them. That hiring manager knows you're the best person for that job. You speak directly to the person that has the ability to either hire you or invest in working with you as a customer or as a client or as a business partner. So your perception of your personal brand speaks to an audience. The next thing that we do is we want to identify the foundation of topics and content, which means on social media, you can start to create content, create value, create and control the perception that you want to have instead of consuming content. You see, the 2 billion plus people on social media oftentimes is consuming content. And so when we're talking about developing your personal brand, we want to talk about creating content. So start identifying, if you want to be perceived as the top health and wellness expert for this niche and this audience, then you want to start to create content for them that controls the perception that you're the expert by providing the best quality content, the most concise trainings, and everything else that's going to help them get the result they want so you can get the result you want. You'll get everything you want in life if you just help enough people get what they want. And so when developing your personal brand, we're really just saying you want to control the perception that people see you as the person that's going to help them get what they want. And then that's going to help you get what you want. And so it becomes a full circle win. And so you want to create content and topics that help your target audience get closer to what they want. Solve the problem that they're going through. Give them educational and entertaining content that's going to help them in some way get closer to what they want. The more content and the more topics you can help people with online, on social media, the more you're controlling the perception. If you have 1,000 pieces of content on social media about helping people with chiropractics, if I look you up, I'm going to probably perceive you as an expert on chiropractics. If you have a perception that you want to create as the top person for XYZ subject, I look you up online, you have thousands of pieces of content on that subject, other people, including myself, are probably going to perceive you as an expert or as somebody who's really good and a specialist on that subject. So your topics and your content are in direct proportion to the perception you want. You want to be the top person for this company, career, path, business, service. Create topics and content that's in alignment with that thing. So if you're in real estate, you create a ton of topics and content all around helping your prospect get the result that they want, even if they never work with you. So if they look you up, if they see you online, you are all over the internet with different pieces of content that control the perception that you're the go-to person. So when they're ready to hire you, when they're ready to work with you, when they're ready to buy your product or service, they've already seen or will see your topics and content and have the perception that you're the go-to person. So the next thing that you have to understand when talking about your personal brand and controlling the perception is your values and what you stand for. What I mean by that is people are in alignment and they like people who are like them. Meaning, if I have a perception about you and you have completely different global views, values, and beliefs, we're probably not going to get along. If your hiring manager believes something, values something, stands for something completely different than you, you probably won't get the job. Companies often hire employees based on their values. So a company hires somebody because they have similar values to the individual and the company's values match. People who get married usually have similar values. People who are good friends usually have similar values. They usually cheer for the same team, have the same religion, have the same political views, work in the same career, believe the same stuff, because then it makes it very easy for us to be in resonance. People who are indifferent and don't agree often have conflict. And so if your personal brand, the perception you want to have, and the content you create is in alignment with the values, the beliefs, and stands for something similar to what your audience has, what your hiring manager has, what your clients and customers have, there's a good chance you're going to have resonance and congruency, which means the perception will be exactly what you want. The outcome will be more likely to be what you want. They'll probably hire you, they'll probably work with you, they'll probably give you what you want, because you're in resonance and the perception is in alignment with what they are looking for. People are not usually looking to hire somebody or work with someone who's out of alignment with their values, beliefs, and everything that they stand for. And so people buy products that are a reflection of what they stand for. They buy a nice car or a nice purse or a nice watch or a nice thing because they value that perception. They want to be perceived as successful. They want to be perceived as significant. And so when you invest or buy something, It's a reflection of what you stand for and your values, in most cases, at least to the world. Why else would somebody buy a super expensive thing? Because it makes them feel a certain way and it helps others perceive them a certain way. And so when producing content and controlling your perception of your personal brand, you want to be hyper aware of how your nonverbal values come off. If you're a health and wellness expert and you say that you are and you produce content around it, but you're overweight, the perception is you probably don't really value health and wellness if I can see that you clearly aren't in good shape. So your unspoken values and your spoken values. If you tell people, I stand for this, I believe this, I value this, that's your spoken values. How you dress, how you talk, how you show up, who you surround yourself with, and all of those things are non-verbal cues of what your values and beliefs and what you stand for are. So knowing that when you're developing your personal brand and controlling perception, your spoken values and beliefs and your unspoken values and beliefs are very important for you to be aware of. A lot of developing your personal brand is simply being aware of all the little things that someone could perceive and judge you as, because you want to be massively aware of all of those things so you can control them in your favor. And the last thing that you should be aware of as we conclude to this free training, before we go into the next one on launching your personal brand, we want to understand, what are some of the best platforms to develop your personal brand on? Our recommendation obviously is Halonis. You can also use other well-known platforms to build your personal brand and develop it on Facebook and Instagram and YouTube and LinkedIn. There's a lot of great platforms where developing your personal brand and housing and hosting your content can be a great place. People are looking you up on specific platforms. Those are most likely the ones you're going to want to develop your personal brand and launch it on. So find the biggest platforms where your audience is hanging out. Halonis, Facebook, Instagram, YouTube, and LinkedIn are great platforms to get started on because they're some of the biggest. So that's where I recommend you start developing your personal brand. And the last thing is outsourcing certain tasks and work. There's a lot of freelancers and software and technology where you can let other people support you in developing your personal brand, whether that's filming content, doing graphic design work, or any of those little things that might not be your skill set, but you want to be perceived as credible, authoritative, as whatever the perception is that you develop your brand around. So in some cases, you'll want to be able to outsource some of those tasks because you shouldn't have to do things that aren't your highest skill set and aren't in alignment with the perception you want. Go get some professional headshots taken. Go get some professional video work done at some point if it makes sense for your brand. And there's a lot of other things you could outsource, like graphic design work and other things. And we'll talk more about that in the next trainings on launching, monetizing, and scaling your personal brand. But we hope you enjoyed this free training and that it helps you in the beginning foundational stages of developing your personal brand.